Hello Malt Major Events, Ralphie here, and we've got a little bit of a minor major event happening right here because we are with Peter for the concluding vlog. This will be number six. Absolutely. Five or six, it's one or the other, but you know, it's not far off. And we're basically going to take a wee wander around a very unusual scene in any Scotch whisky distillery, and it's a bottling plant because Springbank has its own. It's small, it's very much hands-on. Yeah. No big massive computers and forklift trucks and all the rest of it.
It's all done by hand.
All done by hand. Yeah. We like that. Yeah. Lead on, Peter.
Well, this is the bottling hall at Springbank. This is really about keeping folk in jobs. That's what this is about. It's you know, this could be automated for a lot cheaper than it is. We also, you know, by having it here, we're using the same water for bottling as we used for soaking the barley in the steep in the first video. But it's really about, you know, employing local people. It's all done by hand, as we'll see when we go inside.
Thank you.
So this is the bottling hall. Everything's bottled to order here. We don't bottle huge amounts in one go. You know, literally we get an order from Germany for 500 cases. Those 500 cases are bottled. It means that the whisky is in cask as long as possible, which is what, well, to us it's the best place for it to be. You know, there's no point in having whisky, pallets of whisky lying in here in bottles and waiting for somebody to buy them, because you could still be getting a little bit extra flavour from the, you know, from the casks, and so that's where we leave it. This is the vat where we do all our vatting. We'll vat the whisky a year before bottling, minimum a year before bottling. So Springbank 10-year-old, the sherry and the bourbon casks are vatted at 9. They're reduced down to just above bottling strength, to about 48.5%. They're then filled back into the casks. Casks go into the warehouse, and they'll stay there until we get that order, until somebody says, can I have 500 cases? And then enough for 500 cases will be rolled out and is ready to be bottled.
Excellent.
Make our way through. We've got pallets of bottles and packaging and cartons and
cardboards and all the rest of it, yeah.
All kinds of things. I'm very quiet.
That's what happens. That's a mighty big barrel you've got in the corner there.
Yeah, this is one of the smaller vats that we use for, probably more used for cadden heads, single cask bottlings.
Right.
Tending to be done using this one.
So it's a little kind of celerity thing. No, it's not actually.
No, this is for single cask bottlings.
Right.
Only. So when we are bottling, the casks get rolled along the top.
Yeah.
Poured into here.
Yeah.
The whisky then comes through. Everybody stop and strike. Start working again. It's then passed through here, but it's paper filters, basically.
Right, this isn't chill filtering.
Not chill filtering.
Is barrier filtering to remove any particles of charcoal and bits and pieces.
Yeah, bits of charred wood and things like that. They get taken out by these paper filters here.
Yeah.
And then the whiskey comes along.
Mm-hmm.
And we're into the bottling.
Let's see, I'll just follow the pipe along the... Here we are, it's the... Oh, and there's the whisky. Into the bottles themselves. Hello, everybody.
Hello.
I'm just recording this for the internet. An active bottling plant.
Okay. It springs into life. Bottles are cleaned.
Yep.
Quick bit of air passed through them.
Yeah.
Close it out. Stuck onto here where they're filled.
Right.
We can fill four bottles at the moment.
Yeah.
Full capacity would be six.
You've got a little conveyor underneath, so after filling the corking. Hello, corking lady.
Hello.
Every label, every bottle's corked by hand.
Yes.
Then it comes down. And every bottle's checked at this light board.
Yeah.
To make sure there's nothing floating in it, that nothing's gone through the filter.
Absolutely no floaters.
Yeah, we don't want floaters. Once we're happy, they're then sealed.
Yeah.
That's sealed on. Carries on down, we've got the back label. There's a little locator.
It's got a kind of long roll look about it to the labels.
Some long roll we're bottling, yeah.
Yeah.
There's a little locator that just lines up there and then it stamps the label down.
Yeah.
UK duty stamp.
Yes.
Keep the tax man happy.
Oh, he needs to be happy, him, yeah.
Then coming here.
Yeah.
Front label's added. It's going to be stamped with an operation number and with the case number. Then it's put onto the pallet when it's ready to ship.
Thank you.
You can see that was at least.
I wouldn't fancy getting one of those in my forehead.
That was at least seven people handled every single bottle on the way down the bottling line there.
Yeah.
You know, so it's hands on, traditional. The old-fashioned way,
yeah.
And it's packed up and it's shipped out.
Thanks, everybody. Much obliged. There we go.
This is about keeping folk in jobs.
Yeah.
This is about employing local people. That could be automated.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can get machines to do all of these things.
Yeah.
But that wouldn't benefit Campbelltown. It wouldn't benefit the community.
Yeah.
And that's what Mr. Wright wants. Is that,
yeah,
if a machine can do a job, we employ somebody.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Basically.
And again, this is something to mention. It's worth highlighting. That's what Peter's saying here is that the difference that a small distillery can make to a small community, a local community, a little difference can make all the difference, and that's very much the case.
Yeah, I think any distillery is very much a part of the community, whether it's, you know, a traditional one like this or a more modern one. It's, mm-hmm. it's, you know, the distillery, the school, the church and the post office are the,
yeah,
you know, and the local pub probably.
Absolutely. Local pub as well.
And it's, you know, when distilleries shut and things like that, it's like ripping the heart out of a community. And
very much the case, yeah.
I think any distillery owners have a responsibility to, yeah, to the community that they're living in, mm-hmm. you know.
Well, thanks, Peter. This concludes our little tour. We're going to have a short interview with Peter, maybe in the blending room, I don't have no idea. But we'll get something, a personal opinion or two from Peter, and this will conclude our very detailed little interaction with Springbank Distillery in Campbelltown.
Perfect.
Well, it's never perfect. There's always bloopers here and there. And I haven't dropped the camera yet, though.